Today we're installing Windows XP in VirtualBox. For this I have selected Windows XP Home Edition with Service Pack 3 pre-installed. We will start here in VirtualBox by creating a new virtual machine. I am going to give it a name that will help me identify what it is. The version dropdown we will select Windows XP 32-bit. Then we will set the system memory to 3 GB, so we have a decently capable system to work with. For the hard drive capacity, we will go with 25 GB, to give ourselves some room to install some programs and games. We can leave the other hard drive settings as is. I prefer the dynamically allocated option. The system does take a performance hit, but it works well enough for demonstrations. Now that we have created the new virtual machine, we can boot it up. This screen here allows us to select a disk image to boot from. I will browse to and select the Windows XP disk image, and we are off to Windows Setup. We will press Enter here. I like to scroll to the bottom before pressing F8. On this step, we get to work with the hard drive a little bit. We can partition the drive, then press the Enter key for format options. I will just press Enter to see what happens. Interestingly enough, it goes right to the formatting options and doesn't complain about a lack of a partition. Because this is a virtual machine, I am going to use the Quick Format option. Now Setup is going to copy some files. I used to have 2 Windows XP disks with scratches in different places, so to finish the installation, I would have to switch disks several times so all the necessary files could be copied. After the restart, we get a more graphical interface. Spoiler alert, the installation does not take 39 minutes to complete. The default setting for regional and keyboard options are fine, so we can click Next. For the name, I have used Owner for many years. Click Next. I will enter the product key and be back in a moment. The computer name can be whatever it says here. We can change it later if we decide to do something related to networking. Date and time settings are fine, so we can click Next. We can stick with the typical settings for networking and click Next. I miss the little animated drums from Windows 95 when processes are running, like installing start menu items. And we get to restart the computer again. We will be back after the restart. This phase of the installation is called the out-of-box experience. If you purchased an OEM system, this is what you should see the first time you turn the computer on. Let's click Next. On this screen, we get to choose how we want to receive updates. I'm going to leave automatic updates on and click Next. We can click the Skip button on this screen, as the internet connection should be fine if the connection of the host PC is working. As we are setting this up for demonstration purposes, we can skip activation. Then we are presented with options to set up user accounts. We only need one for now, I will call it Owner. Then click Next, and click Finish. Here we are at the desktop on our clean installation of Windows XP Home Edition. In my opinion, a VirtualBox tutorial is not complete without briefly covering the guest editions. This is how we get access to higher color depth and screen resolutions. Click the Devices menu at the top and select Insert Guest Editions CD Image. Then we will get a pop-up to install the guest editions. Click Next. The destination folder is fine. Click Next. We may consider selecting the options for Direct 3D support if you are going to be playing games in the guest operating system. After you make the decision, click Next. Windows XP can't tell if the drivers are compatible, so we will need to click Continue anyway several times to finish the installation. One last restart. We are back after the restart. Now we can click on the View menu at the top and hover over Virtual Screen 1, then select the resolution that we want. I'm going to go with 1280 by 720. Now we are ready to install some software.